While most public schools offer all co-ed classes, Camden-Rockport Elementary is stepping outside the box, trying something new and different. This year, they've created a third-grade classroom made up of all boys. News 8's Erin Ovalle takes us inside the class and shows us what kind of impact the experience is having so far.
Correct.
Mr. Seidel's third-grade classroom at Camden-Rockport Elementary School is set up like any other. The only difference here, there are 18 boys and no girls.
It helps me focus a lot more with not as much giggling, whispering, because usually the girls do that.
Girls, they like different things than boys do.
Austin. Dylan Mackey and Austin Ford are part of a year-long single-sex classroom experiment. Initially, the project was undertaken because of the numbers. There are 44 boys and 27 girls in the third grade. School administrators say creating an all-boys room helped balance things out. But there's also been a side effect, significant student achievement.
They don't have to show off. They don't have to feel like they can make mistakes. And again, when you read the literature, that's what boys have this really hard time admitting, that they don't know the answer, they can't do it.
But test scores show they can do it. They're up over last year in both math and reading. About 44% of his students were above average. 28% tested average, and only 2% didn't reach the standard.
You left out the R.
Mr. Seidel says the key to keeping these active boys focused and enthused is giving them projects that interest them.
Lots of these guys like Legos, and lots of them like the same things that I do.
Some of the favorite lessons thus far included the archaeological dig, the turtle study, and rock and fossil unit. In an effort to keep these boys engaged, they get the freedom to move around and sit where they want.
While Mr. Seidel's all-boy classroom is getting great feedback, the one challenge, he says, is how loud it can get, as you can imagine, with 18 boys in one class. So he introduced the Yakker Tracker, which serves two purposes. One, to promote better communication, and the other is to control the noise level.
While these boys have the potential to get a little rowdy some days, parents like Heather Mackey are pleased to have the option and with the outcome.
I think this age was perfect to get them in there, grab them, and get them excited about learning. And it set the stage for anything next year. It could go either way. So there's a lot of factors. I don't know. I'd be willing to look at it again for sure. Yeah, I think it's been a great success.
And her son Dylan says he'd be happy if next year is the same.
My buddies are nice, good friends. I'd go with an all-boys class again because I'll know what it's like and I'll know what to do.
In Rockport, Erin Ovalle, News 8.
We're going to learn more about the Yakker Tracker. All right, well, the school is now looking ahead to next year to see if they'll offer the single-gender classroom again, and if so, where there'll be an all-girls classroom. The Department of Education supports this option based on the needs of the students in each school.